Okay, so let's get familiar with the revamped curtain wall tool. We'll start by placing three curtain walls on the facade of an office building. The three curtain walls will use three different distribution methods while having the same pattern measurements to begin with. What are the basic options for the pattern distribution of a curtain wall? Click on the exercise number one view. Select the exercise number one curtain wall favorite from the favorites list, and then enter the curtain wall settings dialog. Here you can see curtain wall default settings and the interactive preview for the scheme. Under grid sizes, you will see three options to distribute a pattern: fixed sizes, best division, and number of divisions. We will start by placing the curtain wall with the fixed sizes method on the first office building. Under grid pattern, you can see the sizes of the pattern's columns and rows, so we can place this curtain wall on the model. Just click OK and place the curtain wall on the first building. As anchor points, you can use the top left corner of the placed curtain wall on the bottom. Move your cursor and finish input at its top right corner. You can see the live feedback preview of the element you are placing. ARCHICAD is placing it with fixed sizes, so we can expect a partial pattern to appear at one end. After placing the first curtain wall, open the settings and choose the second pattern distribution option for the columns, best division. ARCHICAD will consider the entered dimensions of the columns and rows and find the closest option to create a full pattern along the entered length, without leaving partial patterns behind. The log that appears, either in logged or unlocked position, next to the measurements will indicate which is fixed and which one can be stretched or squeezed. Leave the log on B column and click OK. Place this curtain wall on the second office facade similarly to the first one. Notice that there is no partial pattern remaining on that option. ARCHICAD calculated and stretched the pattern to fit the length. Open the settings and click the third pattern distribution method, number of divisions. In this layout, you can specify how many times you would like the pattern to be repeated. And now enter 6, for example. The locks are visible in this case as well. Again, at least one measurement has to stay unlocked, so that the software can readjust the pattern. Click OK and place the curtain wall on the last building. What other options can we define for this dialog? What happens if the leftover partial patterns of the curtain wall created with fixed sizes? You will find something called the infill. The infill defines what kind of panel to use, where a full pattern column or row does not fit. Choose the first curtain wall, open the settings, click on infill and choose the distinct panel. If you wish to distribute this partial pattern to both sides, you can adjust the pattern origin at the bottom of the settings dialog. You can choose from various pattern origins for the rows and for the column distributions. You can see that the partial pattern column was filled with the panel type we chose to be the infill panel.